In this series of tutorials, we are learning AutoCAD 3D from start to finish. In the previous tutorials, we have learned 3D basics and we have also solved some exercises based on it. Now, in this tutorial, we will learn revolve command. Revolve command is useful to create shapes like this in AutoCAD 3D very easily. If we try creating these shapes using other AutoCAD 3D commands, then it will be time consuming and sometimes it will not be possible. But with revolve, this can be done very easily. Please watch this complete tutorial to understand revolve concept perfectly. To receive new video notification for more such type of videos, please subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon. Please also like and share this video. We are learning revolve command using AutoCAD 2022, but it will work same with other versions of AutoCAD also. To start new drawing, click here on this arrow and click on CAD ISO, or if AutoCAD ISO is not there, you can also click here on browse templates and click here on CAD ISO and click on open. Then to switch to 3D modeling, click here on gear icon and select 3D modeling. Then click here on unsaved view and click on AC isometric so that it will show Z axis. Then to shift this UCS icon, click here on this arrow and click on show UCS icon. So it will shift that UCS icon on the left side. And it will always keep it there. Then click here on arrow below extrude and we are going to learn about this revolve command. Keyboard shortcut for revolve is REV, enter. For revolve command you will need one sketch which you want to revolve and one axis around which you want to revolve. At first we will create 2D open sketch so that it will create surface. Suppose we will create one 3-point arc. Click here on 3-point, then specify first point here. If your ortho mode is on, turn it off, then specify second point, and suppose I will specify third point here. So I want to revolve this arc. When you revolve single open sketch, it will create surface. Then you will have to specify one axis around which you want to revolve. So for that we will create one line. Click here on line, then take your cursor to this endpoint and take it away. And ensure that you are creating your line in XY plane. Otherwise it will give error during revolve. So track that point. For tracking you will need to have object snap tracking and object snap on. So click and always take the reference of the object you want to revolve. Then only your axis will be created perfectly. Then make ortho on, take your cursor on this side and click, press escape. Then to revolve this curve around this line, again take your cursor to this arrow, click on revolve. Then select object to revolve, click on this curve, press enter. Then you will have to specify axis start point, or you can also define axis by object X, Y or Z axis. So at first we will use this first method, specify axis start point. So I will choose this end point as a start point. Then you will have to specify axis end point. So I will click here on this end point. So here this revolve has been started. Then for revolve you will have to specify angle of revolution. So suppose I want to revolve it by 270 degree angle. So here you will have to type here 270, enter. Now it is displayed as a 2D wireframe. So to give it 3D look, click here on 2D wireframe and click on shade it and orbit it. So here this arc has been revolved around this axis and this shape is created. I don't want to see this grid. So to turn it off, click here on grid mode. And after creation of revolve, if you want to change the angle of revolve, Then for that you will have to click on the object and take your cursor to this arrow, click on it and take it away. Then specify angle. Suppose I want it complete 360 degrees. So type there 360 and press enter. Press escape. So here complete revolve is created. As our sketch was 2D open sketch, therefore it has created surface. And if you want to create solid, then you will have to use close connected shape. Suppose we will again click here on AC isometric. We will pan it on this side. Then to create solid again, we will create one close shape. Suppose this time I want the shape to be vertical. So to work on this face, you will have to use right plane. So click here and click on right. So here XY plane is vertical. So now we will create on this vertical plane. So for revolve, it is recommended that you use polyline so that it will create single object. But if your shape is complicated and if you want to use different objects such as line and circle and arcs, then you will have to convert that shape into polyline. Suppose we will use line and arcs. Suppose click here on line, then specify first point, make ortho on, take your cursor on this side. Suppose I will give length of 300, enter. Ensure that you are creating object in XY plane. If you create object in Z direction, then it will not revolve. Again here I will give 400, enter. Then on this side I will specify 100 or maybe 150, enter. Then below 300, enter. Then suppose I want to connect it to this endpoint, click, press escape. Then I want to add one circle here, so click here on circle, click on this midpoint, take it away, suppose it is 50, enter. Then we need to create one single close object. So we will trim here unwanted objects. For that click here on trim. Then select object to trim. So just click on the object you want to remove. Press enter. So here this shape is created. But now each object is separate. So for revolve we need to have single object. So to convert this object into single object, click here on modify and click on join. Then select all these objects, press enter. So here this single object is created. Then we will have to create one axis around which we want to revolve. So for that click here on line. Again take your cursor to this endpoint. Don't click there, take it away. So always ensure that you create your axis with respect to your sketch. Otherwise, it will not revolve perfectly. Take your cursor to this endpoint, take it away. You can also specify your distance. Suppose it is 175. Enter. Take your cursor on this side. Ensure that your axis is on the same plane as your sketch. If you create it on different axis, then it will not create a revolve. So take your cursor here and click. Press enter. Then click here on revolve, select this profile, press enter. Now we will specify axis of revolution by using this object option. So click here on object, then select this object. So here, now it is creating this revolve. Now it is creating revolve in this direction. Suppose if I want to create revolve in opposite direction from this side. Then for that you will have to click here on reverse. Then it will create revolve in opposite direction. And one more thing, I don't want to start from this angle. Suppose I want to start my revolve from 45 degree from this horizontal plane. So for that you will have to click here on start angle. And you can specify here start angle. Suppose it is 45, enter. So it will start your revolve from that angle. And suppose I want to create it again in 270 degrees, so specify here 270, enter. So here suppose I will just hide this object. For that, click here on isolate objects, hide objects, and select these objects. Press enter. So here this object has been created perfectly. Then again, if you want to connect it back, again click on this object, then click on this arrow and specify here 360 degree, enter. Press escape. So here this object is created. So using revolve we have created one object, but suppose using revolve I want to cut something in this object. Suppose what I will do, I will create one circle and revolve it, and then I will cut it from this object. Again click here on AC isometric. Then plane is vertical, click here on circle, and suppose I want to create one circle. Here it is not showing quadrant, so just press shift, right click and click on quadrant. So here is the quadrant, take your cursor away, suppose radius is 50, enter. Then I want to revolve it around this center axis. So for that again click here on revolve, select this circle, press enter. Then axis start point will be center of this circle, and suppose for end point I will take my cursor on this side, click, and angle I want to specify 360 degree. So here this ring is created, but I want to cut this ring from this object. Then for that you will have to use this solid subtract. So click on solid subtract. Then at first you will have to select object from which you want to subtract. So I want to subtract from this object, then press enter. Then select solids or region to subtract. I want to subtract this one, enter. So here in this way you can use revolve as a cut also. Then there were some more options for revolve. So for that I will turn on this grid. So there were options for revolving around axis. Suppose for that I will hide this object, click on hide object, select this object, enter. So suppose I will create one circle here. Suppose I want to revolve around this y axis. Then for that you can also give revolve by typing REV. So here is revolve, click, select this object to revolve. Then one more option is there, that is mode. So using mode you can control what type of object will be created, whether it will be a solid or surface. So in this case I want solid. Then I want to revolve around this y axis, so click here on y. So here it is getting revolved around y axis. Then specify angle. So in this way you can revolve around desired axis also. So all the options for revolve has been completed. Then complete playlist to learn AutoCAD 3D basic from start to finish is given here. So in the next tutorial we will solve one exercise based on what we learn in this tutorial. Please like, share and subscribe. We will again meet in next tutorial.